Wow, it's almost spring, isn't it?
Yeah.
Feels like it anyway.
Hi, Joe, I suppose you thought I was going to stop you on the para. I seen you and I went to go do a big turn so we're facing the same way.
Yeah. Mate, I've been chucking brown eyes at fishermen for all my life. One day I'm going to grow up and stop doing it. There's one lady fisherman, Vicky Winner, she's just all class.
Yeah.
Every time I see her, I chuck a brown eye at her. I can't, I don't know why. I got to stop it. Yeah, mate. Give us a look.
Oh, fuck yeah. Hey, Aaron.
Where is it?
Hey, Aaron.
Oh.
Do you like getting growlings from the wifey?
Why?
Yeah, I got one.
Did you tell her you bought it?
I said it was half the price.
Do you know Benny and myself have got the biggest man crush on Ian Miller there.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, he's a legend, mate.
You can have a...
Best rod biller in Australia, hey?
Yeah, right. You can have a little play today.
I will do.
I'll let you guys break it in.
I'm glad to see you're right-handed as well.
Yeah, mate.
What braid you got on it?
Tesla. Would you believe that's 12 car?
Yep.
Looks like 8.
Have you used it yet?
I had a little flick. It's there. Yesterday I went out to Manly Lagoon, got a few brim on it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, and awesome.
I thought I'd try something different, eh?
We've got to have a... What's the time now?
8 o'clock.
It's about, I'm pretty sure it's 11 o'clock high.
Yeah, no,
it's a really small high tide too, so if we do Juno, if there's nothing on it, then go into a porter and just try the racks out. One rack brim's worth 20 everything. One good rack brim.
Yeah, I don't know what the racks are, but we've done a couple.
Have you been into a porto before?
I don't know.
It's just over there, right in the back of that. Well, let's go in there first, try that out, and then we'll work our way towards Pitwater.
Let's do it.
Yeah?
Yep.
All right, well, you want to go that way. There's Tyler in here.
Well, I don't know, last week at Botany, off Cronell, the salmon was smashing the whiting.
Ooh, yeah. Years ago, you used to get the salmon in here. Oh, yep. Oh, had one. Nearly broke in the new Certate that I've just acquired. Oh. I don't know. I don't like this rod and reel. Just
no,
missed it. Mullet jumping now, but there was a definite bait chase before. Yeah, got him that time. Ooh! Look at that, big tailor. That's alright, that means we're going to get a feed of flathead today. Alright, it's Roger's turn. No, no, Roger, you here.
No, I'm not doing it, I refuse.
Oh, that's right, you can't use left hand. You can't use right hand.
I can.
It's coming off.
I just don't want to, because it's dumb.
Here, Nathan. Take it back off me. Don't ever get to me again. Unless you want Taylor scales all over it.
Good bait, Rob. Thanks,
mate. Gorgeous outfit. That is one of the most beautiful. Wait till you use a blade on it. I was going to say, you really want to get a worm hook in these sort of places. There's that many Taylor in here, there's going to have to be something nasty. Wants to eat them.
Your lens clean? Mine was dirty all
the
fucking last week.
Oh, it's always dirty. And my, probably, oh, it's whack, straight away. About 1 in 4, 1 in 5clips, there's no volume anymore, so I don't know whether it's the camera or the chip. Okay. Come on, do the fishing.
I think what's going to happen with me is because I was lazy.
Yeah?
If I was lazy, I'm going to get
another one. Why is that? What do you got on a jig head? Yeah, I just...
I like learning lessons the hard
way. I was going to say, I sometimes do that. I'll put a jig head on knowing I'm going to lose it. And then I'll put the worm hook on. But the fish that matter, a lot of people don't like the hookups with the worm hooks, but the fish that matter,
what you got down there?
Grab them.
A little squidgy prawn. Yeah, bro. Give it a go. Put some scent on it.
Oh, they're deadly, man. See how you can see how there's that little rock sticking out like about 4 or 5 meters off, like Roger's coming around it now.
Yep.
This is with the brim fishing, this is what you want to do. You want to go around that rock, along that rock. That's where the worm hooks come in good, because the big brim are going to be chewing on the rock. You know, they're not going to be out here. They're going to be like you want to like roll it around the rock, you know, and you got to keep like looking for, like get it up on the bank or any of the dead timber. See right in the dead wood, right at the back.
Yep.
All of that sort of stuff.
Remember that's on Barara, you picked your lure and pretty much had it right on the edge of the water?
Yep.
Nick Bennett, that was on a worm for that one.
Yeah, it's like, see, I'll just cast in there in the timber. It doesn't matter, I'll just let it sit there for a bit. And it's like when you go to lift it, you'll just feel it tight, like it's snagged, set that hook.
You could be on your swim bike, but with the amount of tether and
all of this. Yeah. Oh, like that. That was one. Oh, that was you, was it? Cheeky bugger. Yeah. Must be one of them big skip casts. Well, it's done now.
Well, that's the game, really.
If you
miss the cast,
just
leave
the
line.
Yeah, you snooze, you lose.
Well, there we go. Weedless
one.
Yep.
I saw that. I was looking at all the oysters in there.
I could see that and I tried to roll over it.
I used to fish with a guy called John Knowles. He used to make the Knowles lures. He's the best hard body fisherman I've ever fished with. And we used to fish water like this. And in all the years I fished with him, I never ever took the boat in to get a lure off a snag. The guy was amazing. He used to just flick, 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 flick every single one.
How many bossing did you run around? Just the one?
Just the one.
Is that the guy we met when we went out fishing that time?
Nah, we're in a fishing comp. This is going back about over 10 years ago. Every winter we used to have these big Walker's Beach, John Buffin inaugurals. Okay. And there was another lure maker called Joe Priest. And Joe and John Knowles were in the middle of a deal together about like making their lures overseas. And they had a fallout. So Joe pulled out a handgun and shot John in the chest and then shot himself in the head. And I was that drunk. Because back in them days, the comps were like, who could drink the most and still fish? Oh yeah, that's a brim.
Brim boat?
Yeah. I was that drunk, I camped on the boat ramp. It was a nice little brim. Yeah, we're on the board.
Beautiful. You around?
Yeah. Oh, he's only little, but they're around.
I got to put it on impressive drag.
Yeah, well, they're doughy. We want them doughy today. That's on a little squidgy wriggler.
Blood wound.
So Nathan's on the board. It was a 1600. Well, what was the rod? How much was the rod?
I don't want to talk about it.
Because we'll send this video to your wife.
Oh, yeah, at least 450.
No, it's 550. They gave me a bit of a discount, so which is good.
See, you look, $1,000 outfit.
There you go.
Well,
I don't know who you think you are, eh?
Mate,
can I buy more expensive outfits than me?
You know what's funny? Like, you're leaning off Aaron, I'm leaning off you.
Well, I said to Roger earlier on the way here, you know, like, that saying about fishing's an art, and there's an old book, Complete Angler, and in it says, doubt not, sir, but angling is an art, and an art worth learning. The question is whether you're able to learn the art. And it's not about experience, it's about the art of fishing.
I'll put it this way, Roger Briley, because me and Nathan used to work together. There's another old guy, his name's Roger as well, who works with us, and he's seen, they all sort of grown as an angler, and now Nathan's obviously growing.
Yeah.
And now he's like, getting into it. Goes out, plastic blade.
It's addictive.
Trying to work out his area.
I like getting the old bait fishermen, you know, like the guys that have been bait fishing all their lives.
And then them over the head.
No. Getting them onto a blade bite. And once you get that going, then that's it, they're hooked. See this? See, we got just rails, right?
Yep.
And then see there's just one little, like 3 meters of trays just in front of us? Well, that's like gold here, because that's that's a structure where they can just sit underneath that there and just come out and feed wherever they want, whenever they want. So we always look for that sort of stuff. Go on. No, to the bloodworm, pulse worm. And do you know they stopped, I asked Wayne to get me a few packets of these, so they stopped making them. Yeah, they only come out 1 year and that's it. We'll see how it's just like off the edge of the rack, drop, yeah. Let it sit there. It's semi-bait fishing, what we're doing. Oh, pliers, we got them in here?
Should
be in the club box. Hold on, we got the Inspector Gadget here.
I thought I'd come prepared.
Wow.
More fishing, yes.
I like his pliers better than I like his rod. See how I got the bail arm open? You just take it straight into the rail. Use my Leckie as a...
Oh, look at that.
Yep. I think it's a flathead, but... Right. Ah, oh, you're gone. Duh. Felt all right, whatever it was. Still.
Okay, I went for quite trying to get a fabulous.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah, I know. But the thing about racks too is like one rack could hold 20 brim. Right. And I found if you do long casts and get one right up there, you're not going to get any betweeners. But if you do little short casts along it, you can continually catch them. Need to go about 2 inches bigger and then they're fun. So it's all three of us had a hook up in the last. If you don't get them on that bite, you don't get them, eh?
I'm dropping the bail arm too,
we'll have another go. No. I'm going to swap sides, I'll go over this side because these are getting bites now. Oh yeah, look at this little posse. Damn, try end. Oh, well, now we got a game plan. He's giving you some fight.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, proper brim. Oh, no, another little one. I don't care, it's a fish.
Nice, Roger.
Well done, Roger. Oh, yeah, it's a better fish.
On the board.
That's a what you call brunch, you know, just light a fire, throw it on the coals. Have you done that with the fish?
No.
Mate, if you're ever going to do it with a brim. You just light a fire, get the coals going, drop him in the coals, and the skin and scales turn into like an oyster shell, yeah. And they just the whole thing pops open, and you just shake the meat in your hand. Do you reckon he did that deliberately? Because I just watched him turn his camera on. I seen him turn his camera on. I thought, oh, he set you up, so I turned mine on too.
No, panning up at the hills, and when I turn back, I can see the wave.
Yeah. It was a setup. Did it break it? Doesn't look good. Oh no, we snapped the cable.
Oh, man.
It's a fish, man. I don't care what. Oh, I hate these things. Oh, you turn the radio down for a bit. They'll get us on copyrights on that one. As soon as it hears, tell me lies. Hold on. I'll give you. Catch and cook, man. I'd like to see someone eat one of them things. Oh, they're horrible. All bone. Oh, that was from doing absolutely nothing, just dragging it behind eating your pizza, so I might do that again. But you need those little things. That's just like the shit fish in here. If you haven't got the variety, you're not going to have the big predators either. In the rod holder. It's the easiest way to catch a squid's rod holder. There, there's a bite. Now give it a twitch. Got him? There's the old rod holder, mate. When things are crook, we got no lecky, rod holder. Oh, I'm on two. Double hook up. Look at that, rod holders.
Go to point.
We don't care, man, it's a fish. We could have a pike off. Stop it. Behave. Let's do it again. You never know, Brim might come along. It's still a Brim the same, so. Back in the rod holder, back to the pizza. What do I want next? What pizza do you reckon I gotta try?
The one at the bottom, right at the end of it again.
These ones? Oh, I might just go half of one. Pull from the rest of it. This is a massive paddock, so if you kept doing drift after drift, you probably will come across some fish. But I don't know whether you want to go to Brooklyn or... I would like to go and target some flathead. We created a rod holder monster.
Have a bit of fun.
Nathan, you should stick your Surtees and your Ian Miller in the rod holder. See, when fishing gets tough, you just put it in the rod holder and let them catch themselves. Oh, we got a pinky. Well, I like to call them snapper. See, it's not just New Zealand that's got snapper, eh? Hey? See the big, see the knob starting to grow on its head? I'm going back in the rod holder. If I still got my Cabanoski on, we'll go to Brooklyn. Oh yeah, let's go to Brooklyn. If you can't get a bite with that, you're not going to get a bite with anything.
But anyway, it ties then from the squid jig down to a ball sinker.
Oh yeah.
Maybe like that much.
Yeah.
So the ball sinker will be dong, 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 and the squid jig's just above it.
Yeah, everyone was buying bigger, heavier squid jigs to get deeper, and then all of a sudden someone thought, let's put a sinker on a little one. You know? Yeah, that'll work. Nothing going down on the sounder? No. Cast, like as you go past, just stay skim along the edge and we'll just cast at them. You got him. I told you if there was a boat that was going to hold a fish. That's a perch. No, it's a blackfish. It's a perch. Awesome. Nice perch.
Perch too.
Look at that. Where is the net? I'll get it for you. See the intensity that Roger wanted us to get the net? That's why I'm going so slow.
You know what my thinking was when I did that cast?
Nice perch. I told you to get the odd one in here. Bring it, bring it to me.
Nice Roger.
Nice Roger.
The tide's running out, I hit the back and just let it go under.
Yeah. Well, I'll probably find the same angle on all of them. But I'll drive around and do another loop because there's probably going to be more perch like that. But there's one, there's more. He's beauty. Look how gold he is. He's spawned too. Look, he's... Oh no. No, he could have been spawned. I don't know, but we're going to go around and try and get another one. A little bream. Well, that's all right. It's a target species right on the keel. And did you see how you got that perfect shot on the keel that time? It's so important to get the keel shot with a plasma.
Looking for that Zodiac, eh, bro? Smiller rod, smiller rod.
Where's his new beauty outfit gone? It's hanging there with no gear on it.
He's seen the Zodiac get that perch.
Fuck off! I'm gonna have to.
Sounds like a slim swim.
No, I'm all comfortable driving because I know I'm putting yous on, I'd rather put yous on them. Yep, sorry about that. Oh, I deserved that. Being a smart ass. I thought, you know what, I'm going to steal your fish. Oh, he might be. I just left it in there a bit longer on that one. Yeah, there'd be more. So, but now we got that perfect tide now for him. No, he's only little. Get rid of that. Get that in there.
What was that?
That was a fish, mate. Look at all the turmoil here. You think that point there would have to be a good spot for juice as well? Look at the pelicans, they sort of know that everyone's coming to clean their fish this time of day.
Smart, eh?
Yeah, they turn up right when everyone's coming in.